What would you say are some of the biggest lessons you've learned up to this point as an entrepreneur?
One of the biggest lessons I learned is if it's worth it, if it's something that is going to give you that success, it's going to be a grind. Mm-hmm. It's going to take a long time. You got to live and breathe it. You have to put 110% in. You know, when the going gets tough, you can't quit. It taught me perseverance. It taught me just to keep going, keep pushing, you know, when times get tough. Another thing that I learned early on that really helped me was the fact that I knew every purchase starts with an emotion. So there's always an emotional hook. As I design, as I think about what we're gonna put out, I always think about what is that emotional hook? What are they gonna feel, right? What pushes me over the edge to wanna buy that piece or spend my money here? And so I always am conscious of that. And so when we built the SaaS brand, it was all about loyalty, family first. I really made it a point to create what the brand stood for as close to what I stand for as men, so I don't ever have to fake it. And so I never turn off. I'm never off the brand.
Right.
I could talk about the brand at 2 a.m. in the morning. And most ideas come around that time, but yeah, I never like have to turn it off or turn it on. Right?
Right.
I live it.
Right.
I live family first. I live loyalty is important. I live, you know, do what you have to do to get what you want. And that can, you know, translate to anything.
Right.
As an athlete, as a family man, being a sav is doing what you have to do to get what you want or what you need.
All right. So there are a lot of people out there who have this side hustle, and they want to turn that side hustle into a full-time hustle.
Yeah.
What's your advice around that?
Anyone that says, I'm going to start a brand and if it blows up, then I'll quit my job. 9 times out of 10, they'll stay at their job only because you have to pour your all into it. Like, I really feel you got to commit. And so for me, I felt like I had to fully commit to the Pacquiao project while I was working. I didn't look at the Pacquiao project as my side. It was 2 full-time jobs. Because I had a family and I had a mortgage and I had responsibilities, I couldn't just jump in at where I was at that point in my life. But it didn't change the way I attacked that project. It was like I had another full-time job that I was fully committed to. And I feel like that's what kind of put me over the hump to be able to make that decision to quit,
right?
So I guess the advice is you gotta go 110. And if that means working 80 hours a week, that's what you have to do.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out these 2 videos right here. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.